Welcome to Real Estate Radio Live, an informative and engaging hour discussing everything you need to know about the world of real estate. Your host, Joe Cucchiara, provides you with insight and guidance on how to buy, sell, finance, and invest in real estate. He also offers real estate tax management strategies, new construction advice, home improvement tips, and much, much more. And now, to guide you around the world of real estate, here's your host and Real Estate Radio Live team leader, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome in. Good afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. Thank you so much for spending some time with us this afternoon. Just before we get started, as usual, just want to remind you, we are with you 5 days a week, Monday through Friday from 3 to 4. You could tune in and listen to us a couple different ways. One is on the radio at KDOW 1220 AM. You could also listen to us live online at kdow.biz. And we'd love to have you download a podcast. That way you could listen to us anytime, anywhere. And we realize that, again, not everybody has the luxury of listening from 3 to 4. So we have developed an app and a podcast. If you go to reradiolive.com, you could download the podcast, listen to the show, any past shows. And the app is at iTunes and all the normal places as well. It's reradiolive.com. We're a live show. We love your calls and questions. Two ways you can communicate with us during the show. One is the toll-free number. That is 1-800-516-1220. You could also text questions to 408-838-9060. If you're communicating or you're listening via podcast, the best way to communicate with us is the 408-838-9060. Most of you know the focus of the show is education and information. We work really hard to have great guests like today and provide you with content and information to help you to be a smarter, wiser consumer in and around real estate. So let me invite my guest in today, Mr. Jeff Morway. He's with Stonecrest Financial. Jeff, good to have you here.
Hey, thanks for having me, Jeff.
Yeah, it's been trying to schedule this for a while. Everybody's schedule. Looking forward to having Jeff on the show. The topic today is alternative lending, and that's Jeff's specialty with commercial and residential properties. Before we get started, Jeff, if you could just give our listeners a little taste of maybe sense of your background, how long you've been in this business, and your current roles and responsibilities with Stonecrest.
Sure. I'm originally from Arizona, and I've been out here in the Bay Area about 35 years. Mm-hmm. Wonderful wife and 21-year-old daughter going to University of San Diego.
Very nice.
Yeah. So as far as the business goes, I opened the business about 30 years ago with a guy named John Freeman. Mm-hmm. And matter of fact, it's kind of a funny story. We were driving down the road, and we were 25, 26 uh-huh. years old. And we saw a sign that said open since 1962. And we looked at each other and we said, gosh, one day would we ever be open 30 years?
That's amazing.
Well, we sure as heck are. So,
there you go.
So yeah, we've been open 30 years. We have a passion for what we do. We love what we do. And that's why we come to work every day.
Very good. Well, tell us, Jeff, a little bit about alternative lending specials. Maybe give us some background, how the dynamics and have changed in lending. As most people know, I'm in conventional, traditional lending. So if someone wants to borrow some money conventionally, Fannie, Freddie, they come to me and they, get a loan, whether it's conforming, jumbo, FHA. That's traditional, kind of traditional financing, if you will, for residential finance. Talk a little bit about what you guys specialize in.
Yeah, it's exactly what you were saying. They come to you for the traditional, conventional.
Yeah.
But as we know, banks have become a little bit tougher on
yes.
guidelines. So that's where I came in the business about, 25 years ago. I started like you did, and then I started saying, well, people really need help when it comes to the bank saying no.
Yeah.
The guidelines are changing, and they need alternatives. They need options.
Right.
So that's what it's all about. Back in the day, a long time ago, it was called hard money.
Mm-hmm.
And that was, someone who had really bad credit, foreclosure was, just basically, threatening to take their house. That's not how it is now.
Yeah.
It's actually tough to get those loans. But, as far as now it's moved toward more people can have good credit, but they're just mm-hmm. self-employed. They're showing a lack of reserves. They might have had one blemish on their credit that's hurting them. And that's why they need the options.
Yeah, and there's so many different reasons, and we'll go through some of those. For instance, someone may want to access the cash quickly and act fast on a building or a property, right, where a bank's just not going to do that quick in some cases. That's one example.
Yeah, I have an example. Last week someone came to me. Mm-hmm. They were buying a $9.2 million building. The bank had approved them at 35% down, mm-hmm. and at the last minute, the bank said, no, we need 45% down.
Mm.
And they were in a tough spot.
Yeah.
So they came to us, and we approved 35% down. We closed in less than a week. They were very, very happy. It definitely cost more than they wanted, compared to the bank, but they got the loan done, and they didn't lose their deposit.
So. Yeah, that's really good. And I think Jeff makes a good point that, there's so many needs for different financing. And when people think back, when you think about hard money, private money, it was very specific to someone who was in dire needs almost, and they didn't have the credit or maybe the wherewithal or maybe the traditional, income. So it was kind of a desperate need, so to speak. And this is completely different now. Jeff and his team are helping people again with another one is big, I know, is bridge financing. Maybe you could kind of explain to listeners why that's so popular now and how people are using bridge financing with you guys.
Well, it definitely depends on what market we're in.
Yeah.
And we're still in, somewhat of a seller's market.
Mm-hmm.
It's changed a little bit over the last month or two. But given the market we've had for the last year or two, the competitive edge for the real estate agents when they – go to make the offer,
mm-hmm.
and they're able to offer an all-cash offer rather than coming in that contingent of the people selling their house. So an example of that would be someone, an older couple that have been there 30 years, 40 years in their house, and they're having a tough time getting all their stuff together,
mm-hmm.
and they don't want to move. They don't want to sell their house before they find another house, and they also might not even qualify for the next loan. So what they do is they come to us for bridge financing. They get to pay for because they have so much equity in the house they're selling, and they get to pay for their house, the new home, all cash, and they don't have to move out of their house right away. So it definitely does relieve a lot of stress for them, and then they know they can at least stay three months to 11 months. Most people stay anywhere from 3 to 6 months.
Right.
It's called bridge financing.
And I don't want to speak out of turn, so you guys will do commercial, residential. Will you entertain, mobile home parks, different things that are unordinary, or just is it pretty strict to commercial and residential, or will you guys look at different things of that nature?
We always look at all types of unique properties, and that's another reason for alternative lending. In your question with the mobile park, we've done one of those.
Okay.
But we try not to do what we don't know too much of. So on our side, we do not do development or construction.
Yeah.
Because we just like to, when we underwrite files, mm-hmm. we want to do what we know and what we're good at. So as far as unique properties, there's so many on the commercial side, but a lot of the banks will not lend on, vacant
mm-hmm.
vacant properties,
right.
And it's just a matter of when the bank says no, if it doesn't debt service totally mm-hmm. properly, and also amount of down payment. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the banks want a lot more down than we ask for too.
Yeah. Jeff, do you guys do land loans? I know, traditional banks used to do those, and I know maybe one that does it now, and some of the private banks may entertain it depending if you have assets or money with them, et cetera, et cetera. Those are a little more challenging, right? I mean, some of the land loans?
Yeah, the land loans, or lot loans, as they call them, too, can be challenging for anyone.
Yeah.
There are a couple of banks, and that's one thing from me, and I think Joe knows this. When you call me on the phone, typically I'm going to always give you some sort of direction whether I can do the loan or not.
Right.
So the alternative lending, if a bank can do it, then, of course, you're told that this bank can do it. But as far as lot loans, we specialize in doing lot loans,
mm-hmm.
funding lot loans. Land loans in outskirt areas that don't have the utilities or the improvements, those are a little tougher for us.
A little tougher, yeah.
Yeah.
But you guys will entertain a lot loan, for instance, something someone's getting ready to build on.
Oh,
something
sure.
of that nature.
Sure, and you know, and then also give them, you know, take them down the road toward the construction financing
right.
with you or whoever.
Very good. So give us kind of, I mean, the radio is best for the best stories we could tell, illustrations, if you will, over the sound of the airwaves here. Give us some examples of maybe two or three, you know, Joe, or, you know, this is why someone would come to us. Can you give us a couple of those kind of examples
sure.
for the listeners?
Sure. For example, if someone needs to close quickly.
Yeah, that's a good
one. And a lot of, we've had a lot of what's called flippers mm-hmm. over the last probably 2, 3, 4, 5 years. And a lot of them, you know, make offers that they can close in 10 days.
Right.
And some of them make the offers before they even have the money. So, you know, they'll come to me and say, hey, listen, Jeff, I need to close real quick on this, all cash. So we definitely have helped those people with the new purchase, and then sometimes, you know, not only the acquisition but also the construction side of that, because we offer investors a lot of lines of credit.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of our people are equity rich. They have tons and tons of rental properties, but they're liquid cash
yes,
poor.
Yes, right.
And the banks don't love that. The banks, because they're self-employed,
mm-hmm.
they don't really show maybe all their income, or they're showing a lack of reserves,
right.
and that's why they're asking for cash.
Yeah.
So they come to us, and we give them a line of credit, and it's really kind of, we're one of the few private money lenders that will give a line of credit. And the nice thing is then you only pay interest on the portion you use.
Yeah, you and I were just talking about that, about potential client of mine that ultimately is still going to need it. He's just delaying some of his paperwork. But that was great to hear, and it's a good reminder that you guys are one of the few that I know of that will do the line of credit. That makes so much sense for some people. I mean, when they're really not quite sure, let's say ultimately they might need 200 or 300 or 500 or whatever the number is. But maybe they need 300 right up front, but they don't anticipate the other 100 or so maybe for several months or something. That's a benefit for them, isn't it?
It definitely is. And the effectual rate, because they might go to, you know, another private money lender, and that lender might say it's this rate.
Right.
And, you know, again, as we have talked, you know, Joe, in the mm-hmm. past, the interest rates on private money are quite a bit higher
sure.
than
yep.
Conventional rates. So, you know, it's best that you only borrow on what you're using
exactly.
at this time.
Yeah. All right, what we're going to do is take our first break. We come back, we're going to talk more about alternative lending, and Jeff Morway is here in the studio with me with Stonecrest Capital. Maybe you have, or I should say financial, maybe you have a question. Do you have a scenario? Do you thinking about Jeff might be able to help you out? 1-800-516-1220. This is Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We'll be back with you in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We have in studio today joining us, our guest is Jeff Morway. He's with Stonecrest Financial. And we're talking about alternative lending. Jeff is a specialist in that area, commercial, residential. And the first segment, we covered a little bit about what that looks like, some of the options. We're going to continue to give you some examples. If you have any questions for Jeff, maybe you're wondering, gee, you know, I don't really qualify for traditional financing. What about a foreclosure? What about a short sale? What about this? I mean, these are all questions that we want to hear. 1-800-516-1220, or you could text the questions to 408-838-9060. Jeff, a couple things that come up a lot I want to chat with you a little bit about is, one is cross-collateralization. Maybe you could explain to the listeners a little bit about why that's important. Maybe you talked a little bit in the first segment how
sure.
some people have multiple properties, short on cash, but maybe they have four or five rental properties or a commercial or something that's, you know, they have good equity in.
Sure.
So talk a little bit of how you guys could structure deals based on something like that if you have multiple properties.
Yeah, you know, once again, we try to tailor the deal for the person's specific needs. So, you know, if they have three, four, or five properties and they want to get a larger kind of line of credit, because there's some people out there who say, I just want to be ready when the next next type of deal comes in, I want to make a purchase. I don't really have the cash to do that. And right now, in this day and age, you have to be ready. And if you have a nice line of credit, then you're ready to do it. And also, if you have a line of credit and you can't get it through the bank, you can get it for emergency purposes.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'll have some people that come to me and they'll have, you know, $1 million property, but they want to borrow $1 million. You know, and I say, well, I can't do that. That's 100% financing. But if you have another property that's worth, you know, $500,000-$600,000, and then maybe you have a third property, you know, as long as we're at about 60% loan to value.
Yeah.
That's where we, you know, we want to keep safe.
That's about a threshold. So, for example, maybe someone has a commercial property, two other residentials, and let's say overall they have, $2 million in equity, and they want maybe $700,000-$800,000 or $500,000-$600,000, depending, because they want to do some work on it or rebuild something or do something. I mean, those are types of things. In other words, you could do deals that aren't necessarily tied to the property that they're really going to be doing some work on or needing some. You could look at other properties, other assets.
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah, we will. And like you said, it all comes down to if they want a line of credit or they're going to use all the money right away, we can give them a loan too.
Okay. The other thing let's talk about for a couple minutes, which comes up a lot in my business, and you see it. Someone will need some money. Let's say someone passes away. There's a trust. There's an irrevocable trust. Let's talk about that separately, because then we have some LLCs and stuff. Let's just stick to the trust part. Traditional lenders, trusts aren't too much a problem. You know, the traditional trust, not a problem. But when you get into irrevocable trust, and some of these ones are a little tricky, or you have some situations where it may take a long time, or they may have some legal issues to go through, this is another example of where you guys could come in and potentially, depending on the situation, lend money, right?
Yeah, definitely. You know, even with the trust, whether it's irrevocable or revocable, you know, depending on how many errors there are, it's just so complicated to go through the bank.
Mm-hmm.
And the bank just really drives people crazy on that. So typically they're going to come to us, whether it's a reverse 1031 exchange, which you have to pretty much, you know, probably 60, 70% of the loans go through private money. There's so many reasons, especially when they're going through this, and they're also going through a lot of pain at that time, and they don't want to have, you know, all this paperwork, which is hard to find in the house. So there's a lot of reasons, several, I use this word, plethora, I love that word, plethora of reasons for people to speak to us as a second opinion. And definitely if you can, you know, if I feel you can get the bank loan, then I'm always going to send you that way, you know, right away.
And I know it's always on people's minds, so let's just talk about it, because that's what we do is we give all the people the details and the goods. So what I am going to do is we're going to take a break. I'm going to come back. I'm going to talk a little bit about, you know, the rate structure, how you guys look at deals, the kind of the rate range, the fees, those types of things, because I know that's on people's mind as well. All right, we're going to take another quick break. When we come back, more conversations about alternative lending. If you have any questions, 1-800-516-1220, text 408-838-9060. This is Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We'll be back with you in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We have joining us in studio today, Jeff Morway, who is with Stonecrest Financial. alternative lending, and he is a specialist, Jeff is, in commercial and residential properties. Alternative lending is what we're talking about. Jeff, I want to talk a little bit about, in this segment, rates, fees, structure. We know, you know, when we go to look for a traditional rate, everybody's looking at bank.com and this.com, and it's just kind of crazy all over the place, but there's Fannie, there's Freddie, there's Jumbo. There's pretty structured, although it's still kind of a mess, the whole lending industry, quite frankly, to be honest.
Oh, yeah.
It's a mess.
Oh, yeah.
People need money, but it's a mess, I'm
exactly.
telling you. Anyway.
Buyer beware.
Yeah. Talk a little bit about the rate structure in terms of ranges. Like, I know it varies, and it could vary a lot depending on the profile of the client, the building, all kinds of different stuff. But talk a little bit about traditionally maybe ranges and rates.
You know,
and
it really does vary.
Yeah.
You know, and hopefully everybody's sitting down out there. so your traditional conventional financing is anywhere, you know, from, you know, lows to the threes to the, you know, to four, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right around there right now. So if someone has, first of all, on the what they would call now portfolio lending, or, you know, sort of the old days subprime, if someone has a foreclosure, or, you know, on their record, or one day out of foreclosure, one day out of bankruptcy, or even one day out of a short sale, they're typically, if their credit score has improved, where their credit scores, you know, even in the sevens, because they've, you know, been out of the short sale for quite a while, or their bankruptcy, and it's in the 700s, they can even get a loan probably anywhere from 5.5% to 6%.
Okay.
And the points should be pretty low. It could be 1-1.5 points. For more of the lines of credit, you're going to see anywhere from, you know, 8-10%.
Right.
And that kind of stuff on private money. Anything to do with private money, you're pretty much the best you're going to see is a low, and that this is, you know, if someone is just perfect and the loan to value is like 30%,
yeah.
7%.
Yeah.
But typically they're going to be, you know, 7-10-11% if
Got
it's
it.
A second mortgage. Sometimes if it's a second, you're going to pay a little bit higher. So we do lend on, you know, second mortgages too.
Yeah.
So,
well, it's to be understood. I think when people understand this business and traditional money versus it's a risk based, and everybody should know that in the basis of traditional lending. So if it's private money and there's the underwriting guidelines, there's nothing like that. It's completely different. So
if you want to give me, you know, what I'll do is give you an idea, too.
Yeah.
And the fact, when I meet with you or whoever meets with mm-hmm. you, you know, always ask. It has to benefit. You know, it has to make sense.
Right.
And the reason people borrow private money, and they're usually pretty happy, they're not desperate. They just kind of go, hey, these holding costs, whatever the
mm-hmm.
costs are, whatever the interest rate is, it makes sense in the situation that I am in right
exactly.
now, and it's going to be a helping hand. And, you know, later on I'll give you our underwriting,
yeah.
what we look at, because it's, you know, it's a lot, it's really different from the bank, the way the bank underwrites a file.
Yeah, no, I agree with you 100%. They know what they're getting into. It's none of this old days where people think about 50, 60 years ago loan sharking. It's not like that at all. People understand they have a need. For instance, you mentioned holding costs. There's another thing that comes up to me a lot that I hear people, and it's the flipping or making a decision on a property. If someone feels like they need to make a decision on a property quickly and they need a private loan because of that, or specialists like you, and let's say, just for sake of this conversation, it might cost them another $10,000, $15,000, $20,000, but they're going to make a several hundred thousand potentially on this property. That's something that they'll do.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely have worked with investors that, you know, in 1 year they've made over $1 million, $1.5 million, and they look at me as their golden child.
Right.
So, you know, as far as, you know, they're always going to make the lion's share. We
sure.
definitely, you know, we're definitely not, we're just in it for the lending end. We're dating you.
It's got to be a win-win for everybody.
Exactly.
All right, we're going to take another quick break. We come back more. If you have any questions for Jeff about alternative financing, 1-800-516-1220, or you could text 408-838-9060. We'll be back with you in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Thank you again for joining us this afternoon. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We have just a couple segments left here. We're joined in studio with Jeff Morway. He's with Stonecrest Financial, alternative lending specialist. We're talking about how you arrange to get financing when it's out of the little generic box in which we lend in our world. And there's all kinds of different reasons. You know, you need a property quickly. You need decisions made quickly. We talked about needing financing. If you're in a trust that the lenders won't lend on, and we're going to talk a little bit now about other little caveats here that Jeff could help with. For instance, Jeff, I know that most lenders, the only ones I know of is, there are a few.
99%
yeah,
of the banks.
Right.
Will, yeah.
And then sometimes the other little thing that I'll tell people too is, you know, if you have a private relationship with a private bank, let's say, you know, a private bank, and you got a bunch of money in, sometimes they will do different things.
Oh, definitely.
But not everybody has several million dollars to put in a bank to try to do some. So one of the other things is LLCs. A lot of lenders don't like LLCs for obvious reasons. They want people to be liable, right?
That's right.
So talk about, do you guys do that? How does that work?
Or yeah, you know, deal? we work with a lot of investors, mm-hmm. and investors don't want to take it under their individual
right.
name a lot of times. So they'll either put it under their LLC or corporation, and definitely as long as we receive the articles of corporation, the bylaws, and the corporate resolution, mm-hmm. we're fine. And, you know, it definitely says that they're allowed to be the signer for the,
yeah.
the corp. And you know, quite seriously, you know, I think the banks should be fine with it, but for some reason they have this guideline that they're not. And, several times we don't even ask for a personal guarantee unless we feel we need to.
Yeah, very good. And again, most of what you do is driven off risk-based. When I say risk-based, for instance, you mentioned earlier, is that about you'd like to see if you're loan-to-value about 60%, whether the different transactions? I know it could,
actually,
could vary.
Actually, it goes higher. You know what I mean? So we've been around a long time, so we've made that's made us better. I mean, we've made a lot of mistakes over the 30 years, and that's how you grow.
Yeah.
So then you become better underwriters
right.
and understand how to look at a
right.
look at a file, and that's what we're good at. So what we look at, back in the old days, you used to look at just, okay, it has a lot of equity,
yeah.
I'm going to do the deal, and that really doesn't help the client totally. And if you're really going to try to help the client, you got to look at, there's five different sections that we look at. One is obviously the equity,
mm-hmm.
and we will lend up to 75% on
okay.
a bridge loan. So in a purchase, we'll 30% down. Sometimes we've done as little as 25% down. So we definitely look, you know, depending on the client profile.
Yeah.
Then the other thing, so the five things we look at is the equity. Does the ability to repay make sense?
Mm-hmm.
We don't ask for the tax returns. We don't beat the client up or all that. We actually talk to the client and just kind of says, does it make sense what they're saying?
Okay.
We're pretty logical guys. And then three, and we are a direct lender. We're the ones who make the decision.
Mm-hmm.
And then three, are we benefiting the client? We're not going to pay off their first mortgage if
mm-hmm.
it's at 3%. And four, what is the exit strategy? How do they plan to pay us off? We don't
right.
want to put them in a position where they're going, I don't know how to pay you off.
Yeah.
So we'll always talk about that and have a plan of action. And lastly, because of 2008, this one came up. It's the character of the client. And, you know, if we feel the character is not there, which we've seen in the past,
mm-hmm.
back in 2008, all the people that were good people, we worked out beautiful plans with them. All the people that didn't have the best character, they were tough files for us to handle.
Yeah. With a couple minutes left in this segment, let's talk a little bit about the, we mentioned earlier, but so you guys will also look at and consider deals with someone just out of bankruptcy, foreclosure, short sales. Talk a little bit about that. So I think the idea again is, if you're having a trouble or a struggle with traditional lending, and you have some loan to value, or you have some money, or you have some, I mean, you guys will look at these deals case by case.
Yeah, let me give you a perfect example.
Okay.
I have a gentleman, wonderful man. He had his own business about 6-7 years ago, self-employed, and you know, he was doing a startup, and you know, boom, he had a blemish on his credit. They didn't make it, and he had to declare bankruptcy for one reason or
mm-hmm.
another.
Right.
And then he went to work, because he's a very smart guy. He went to work at Amazon and Google, and now he wants to buy a house with his wife, but they're saying, you know, well, you have the bankruptcy right. on your credit, and they, you know, it's one blemish from the past when he was self-employed. Mm-hmm. So I'm able to get him a loan now. His credit score has improved tremendously, and he has Google stock, and so his loan, he's getting a loan. It's a little bit higher rate. It's at 5.75%, but he's still able to get into a $1.8 million home. So
yeah. And the other thing to mention, too, which I think is important in these equations, and I don't want to forget about it, is interest only. Because
sure.
let's face it, right? I mean, a lot of people might be listening to this show going, man, 5.5%, 6%, 7%, man, fully amortized. No, no, no. These are interest only loans. I'm not saying for, but what, 99% of the time? Most of them are.
Yeah,
right?
99% of the time, they're interest
cash
only.
Flow.
But we actually, you know, talk to a client, too. Some clients say they want it amortized,
yeah.
and we talked to them about it. They have a tremendous amount of income. But, you know, here's the thing. When you take one of our loans, you're always in control.
Yeah.
We have no prepay penalties.
Right.
So you can always pay more if you. I always tell the client, take an interest only. If you have a tough month, then you only have to make the interest only payment.
Yeah.
But if you want to always pay more, we want you to.
Right.
So.
All right, we're going to take our last break. We're going to come back, finish up. Again, if you have any questions for Jeff, 1-800-516-1220, or you could text 408-838-9060. This is Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. We'll be back with you to finish up in just a couple minutes.
For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Welcome back to Real Estate Radio Live, streaming live on iHeart, TuneIn, and KDOW.biz. For more information on today's topic or guest, just visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Again, your host for Real Estate Radio Live, Joe Cucchiara.
Welcome back in. Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. As we wind down the show, just a couple minutes left here. A lot of good information shared today by Jeff Morway with Stonecrest Financial. We're talking about alternative lending. He's the specialist in that area. Just with the a couple of minutes left to go, Jeff, a quick summary. We want to make sure people know, you know, the great part about this is usually cash flow. People are trying to make ends, you know, trying to make a deal work one way or another. So keeping that low, you talked about interest-only payments. But also, I think the other cool concept, depending on the loan-to-value and this deal structure, you guys also offer deferred payments. Talk just a minute about how, you know, that's part of some of the structure of your programs as well.
Yeah, sometimes that's a needed part of the loan when it comes to, especially when it comes to bridge financing. Because they already have a loan
right.
on their property before they sell it.
Mm-hmm.
So as long as the equity's right, then we will defer the payments on the bridge financing until they sell their home. And then it just adds up and they pay us off.
Yeah, so for an explanation purpose real quick, that would
Thank
mean
you.
Someone that, you know, let's say the bridge is $500,000 and the month, or the I should say the payment's going to be $5,000. They defer those for 2 months, and then they end up it's $510,000.
Exactly.
On
exactly.
there, the deferred part of it instead. It makes sense. Okay.
Yeah.
Very good. So before we let you go, just a couple minutes left. I mean, this is a great service. You guys have been around for 35 years, and you and I were talking off air. I think it's really important, too, is that, you know, you meet a person, you find out their character, you find out how they get it. This is a business of helping people, isn't it?
It's big time, and people really have to entrust, especially when it comes to private money or
right.
hard money or whatever we want to call it.
Mm-hmm.
There's a need for this type of loan
right.
out there. If it's handled by the right person, then you know you definitely need a specialist for
mm-hmm.
it, someone who understands it and will kind of look at the loan and also tell you, hey, no, this is not the right loan for you.
Yeah.
So.
And you guys, the other part of it, too, I want to make sure, is that when someone comes to you, this is what you guys are really good at, too, and you mentioned it earlier, I just want to highlight it, that you guys will look at it, And if it's something that doesn't suit you, you might have some other suggestions or thoughts for people, right? You're just not going to say, sorry, see you later.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, if someone sends me a loan, let's say Wells Fargo sends me a loan, I get a lot of turndowns from the banks. I mean, sometimes I can look at it and say, geez, Joe can do this loan.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'll send it back to Joe. So, you know, look, the most important thing is you know someone who's a specialist who's going to look at your needs, what you need to, you know, what your goals are.
Right.
And then I'm going to, you know, tailor a loan for you or send direct you to someone who can give you cheaper financing.
Yeah. So I'm going to take that sound bite and just keep play it on a loop when you said Joe could do this loan. I'm going to take that sound bite and I'm just going to play it, replay it.
Joe can do this loan.
Before we go.
I'm hypnotizing him. Joe can do this loan.
Before we go, Jeff, I want to make sure, what's the best way to contact you if someone wants, you know, more information about you, your company, maybe structuring a deal? What's the best place to do that?
Yeah, you can reach Jeff Morway at 408-234-4121. That is my cell phone. And then my direct line is 408-260-5845. Either one, you know, I'm pretty much available all the time. I'm always checking my
emails.
He
is, let me tell you.
Even on the weekends.
And he'll return his calls quickly. All right, Jeff, I want to thank you for sharing some time with us today. It's very informational. Thank you so much.
I appreciate you having me.
This is Joe Cucchiara with Real Estate Radio Live. Thank you for tuning in today. Thanks for sharing some time with us. We'll be back with you tomorrow with more to finish up the week. Take care. Have a great afternoon.
You've been listening to Real Estate Radio Live. For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Log in, download our podcast, discover more at reradiolive.com, reradiolive.com.